This video will show you how to construct confidence intervals for the difference of two population means. For this tutorial, I'm going to be using the LA County Ozone Random dataset from the Rguroo User's Guide repository. If you would like assistance loading this dataset, please watch our video specifying data on an inference for population means. Now take a moment and pause the video and consider the problem I have presented in front of you. From the Analytics pane, scroll down to Analysis, and then click on Mean Inference. Now let's select the dataset LA County Ozone Random. For variable 1, we are going to choose September, and for variable 2, we are going to choose February. Rguroo automatically fills in the summary data in the Population 1 and the Population 2 boxes below. These boxes also give you the ability to change the labels for these populations. I would like September Ozone and February Ozone to be my labels of choice. Now, to construct the confidence interval for the difference of these two population means, scroll over to the Population 1-2 tab. Here you'll see two subtabs. One for the confidence interval, and the other for the test of hypothesis. You'll notice that Rguroo also conveniently defined the two means of interest. Since we are constructing a confidence interval, we are in the correct subtab. Rguroo can compute confidence intervals using two distribution-based methods and two bootstrap methods. You can also specify the confidence level you are interested in constructing. The default setting is 95%. And over to the right, you will see the assumptions box. If you are interested in learning more about these assumptions, please reference our video, Assessing Assumptions for Mean Inferences. We are going to leave this box alone, since we are to assume unequal variances in this problem. I'm going to select all four methods and also show the histogram that displays the results of the bootstrap methods. It's important to keep in mind that Rguroo removes all cases of missing data on the variables involved before performing an analysis, and that the bootstrap methods can only be used if raw data is provided. Once we have selected the methods of our choice, click the preview icon, and you're done. All confidence interval reports begin with the data summary table, and each method chosen will display the lower and upper confidence intervals. The t-based confidence interval will have an added column for the degrees of freedom in the center of its output, and the green text in the bootstrap-based confidence interval tells us the number of bootstrap replicates used, the difference of sample means, and the standard error estimate based on those bootstrap samples. So with this analysis, we are 95% confident that the difference in mean ozone levels for September and February range from 0.014 to 0.023. You'll notice our histogram has two pairs of vertical lines in the graph. One set marks the 95% percentile confidence limits, and the other the BCA confidence interval. We can also see the observed sample value denoted by the green triangle. Now, if you are interested in changing the number of bootstrap replicates, scroll up to the Details button, select Test of Hypothesis, Methods and Details, then click on the Simulations Methods tab. Here you can change the replication as you see fit. Now, every time you run a bootstrap confidence interval, your results are going to vary. If you would like to reproduce the same bootstrap results, you would need to specify a seed. I suggest picking your favorite number. It's easy to remember should the settings reset. For more information about constructing confidence intervals for the difference of two population means and the various methods to do so, please reference the chapter Inference for Population Mean from our user guidebook.